I mean, one of my, certainly my experience in what I call the strategic creativity, which I come into a painting process, or if I'm in my business context working on a project where I need to have some clear space to create something new, a new idea, a new proposal, or a new way of approaching something. The preparation stage is actually quite important, and I mean, for my painting work, this space is beautiful. I come in, the first thing I do is just get the physical space kind of organized. If I need to move something around and get my stuff put away, I would then look at what the work I need to do for the day. I might bring that out and just set it on the table. But even just looking around the room and say, okay, what am I going to be about? It just keeps me busy. I don't have to make any decisions. I'm mainly just responding to what's out there. And that allows me to kind of engage the space, I think, as well. Just physically move around the space and everything's there. And then I would sit down. I'd often sit down over in the corner here and look at what I'm going to be working on. Or I'd bring out some of the artists that I appreciate or that may be related to what I'm going to be looking at. And allow them to just speak into my space, you know, to see what they're doing with color, and I can actually often feel an energy rising then. I'd often take some time just to pray into it as well and just quiet myself. I allow myself just to be quiet, listening. Even now there's a silence around the church. It's being in that quiet place, but realizing I'm not alone, even. And maybe intangible, but it actually becomes tangible as well, of understanding that I'm here and this is good. And this is good. God is good. I'd often start drawing. Even if I'm not using the drawing for what I'm going to be doing next, but it's actually just to engage the physical process of drawing again and mark making. It's a rehearsing for an athlete. It might be the connection there would be just simply warm up. You're warming up your muscles. But as you warm up your muscles, you're also engaging your mind and becoming aware. So even though it's a very simple routines, provide a place for my mind then to engage what I'm really interested in. Taking that space is difficult in our modern context, but we need to do that if we're going to be in a place of real focus. Routine frees the mind to engage the next level of interest. And the routine itself provides a platform they can then explore. The routine creates a context in which you can be spontaneous. So spontaneity can now happen within a place of intentionality. I want to move in this direction. I don't know where it's going to lead me. So I need to be, in that sense, spontaneous, exploring, looking for new possibilities. But because of that filter of, I know where I'm going, you can then judge what's going to help me get there. And oftentimes you're caught by surprise. And that's where that spontaneity it works side by side with the logic. You know, it's left brain, right brain, right brain, left brain, moving back and forth. I've sometimes finished paintings that I only recognize I finished afterwards. I'm working on it. Everything's wet, ready to go. I'm thinking, this is not there yet, but for this today, it's done. I come back the next day and realized I don't want to touch it. What's right or what's wrong actually changes in significance then. So I look at it and say, well, some parts of it don't quite work necessarily. But either if you change those, you have to change the entire painting, or you recognize that adds a dissonance. Or for me, a bit of real life, where real life is messy and real life doesn't always fit. And I don't mind a painting that has some elements of it that says, that's a mistake maybe, that doesn't quite work. It says, yes, that's very real. For me, it gives it a life and a vitality. But that's where, you know, so let that mistake just stay.